shit, guys. Fire our shit.
Well, howdy folks, and welcome back to the garage. Today I'm looking over the new Warhammer tanks, specifically the Predator UM that's coming to Blitz in the near future. In the Warhammer 40k universe, the Predator is based upon the Rhino armored personnel carrier of the Space Marines. Having removed the troop transport features and upgrading with ammunition stores, chassis reinforcements, extra armor, and weaponry hardpoints in order to allow it to fulfill the role of a more conventional tank. Here in Blitz, the Predator resides at tier 7 as a heavy tank with competitively spec'd armor, mobility, and firepower, but with likely one of the worst concealment ratings. I don't know for sure, but by God, as this vehicle appears to be the new standard in gigantic within Blitz. Check this out. Maybe this is a gentle preparation for introducing the ultra-massive Japanese heavy tanks that are available in the PC version of World of Tanks? Time will tell on that one. Frontally, Predator's well-armored on both the hull and turret with maximums of 130 and 150 millimeters respectively, although we can see here in this image from our friends at GamesModels3D.com, these thicknesses are not applied evenly to all areas, with the turret appearing somewhat stronger, while the cupola, as is typical, is a definite weak spot. Side armor is spec'd to 75 millimeters, but we can see here that it is certainly not on the majority of the profile, but in either case, putting rounds through the side armor is definitely a viable option for weaker gunned opponents, as is the rear of the vehicle. Mounting the 80mm autocannon Mark IV B weapon, the Predator can penetrate 165mm on average with regular AP and a 210mm with a spicy APCR, for those situations where only spicy ammo will do. As an autocannon, the 80mm holds 3 rounds in its magazine with a reload time of 1.5 seconds between shells and 11.27 seconds to load a new magazine, as I have the vehicle configured. Average damage per AP shell is 180 hit points and 145 hit points for the spicy APCR. If you can pen a vehicle with the HE and its 38mm of penetration, you will be rewarded with 250 hit points of damage on average. Not a whole lot as far as HE goes. As with all outer loaders, burst damage is key, and this 80mm will dispense 540 hit points of damage in the 3 seconds or so that it will take to unload all 3 AP shells in the magazine. Not too bad. This gun is also fairly accurate with 0.32 dispersion rating and an okay aim time of 4.3 seconds. And with a maximum rated speed of 32 kilometers per hour, this is not the fastest heavy out there at tier 7, but it's still competitive, as is the 28 degree hull traverse speed and the turret traverse of almost 43 degrees per second. Engine power is 682 horsepower, and as configured weight of 48.54 tons, this provides a power to weight ratio of just over 14 horsepower per ton, which isn't too bad as far as heavy tanks go, but acceleration and hill climbing will not be what you might call brisk. So, that's a pretty quick rundown there. How would I play this tank? While the frontal armor is good at tier 7, the autocannon is not ideally suited for the typical peekaboom brawling. And while the gun is very accurate and time between shells is only 1.5 seconds, the magazine reload is 11 seconds, which doesn't eliminate it from the sniper role, but doesn't make it ideal either when combined with its 280-meter view range. As well, getting caught out alone with its mediocre traverse speeds will make it vulnerable to lights and fast mediums. A support role is likely ideal here, where with proper angling, it will be able to bounce hits to the frontal armor, and burst damage will supplement the output from your frontline brawling heavy tanks. Well folks, there you have it. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like down below. If you really enjoyed this video, hit the subscribe button, let me know in the comments. As well, be sure to visit my social media pages, both on Facebook and Twitter. This is where I post info that, well, not belonging in a video, it's worth taking a look at. I would also like to give a shout out to my Patreon supporters. You folks are making a huge difference for me. If you like what I do and enjoy the community all of us humans are building, please consider supporting the mission via my Patreon page. There are quite a few options with varying levels of support. Maybe one of them will suit you. Links to all things in the video description. All right, folks, thanks very much for stopping by and watching. I'll catch you next time.